extend our thanks to the University Concert Series, the wonderful Grand Old Lady, the Missouri Theater, the Columbia Convention and Visitors Bureau, and piano distributors, without whom we would not have instruments like this. So, round of applause for them. And as you know, every John William Boone concert started with a spiritual. And here, to perform that for us once again, is Columbia's own Willie Cottrell.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand.
Thank you, Willie. Doesn't he do a wonderful job? I get the easy job for the Young Turks concert. They, as we were getting everything all organized, I told them that this is not just a chance to show off their talents as Young Turks, but it is also my succession planning and Masters of Ceremony in training. So, I'm not going to do a whole lot of talking here. They're going to make sure that the flow of the show keeps going. So, hiss if they get off, carry off kilter a little bit, and cheer them when they get it right, and all that. Let's encourage these guys all we can. We're going to start the show with the 2014 Junior All-Time World Championship, World All-Time Piano Playing Champion. Was that right? Close enough. A repeat offender here, Daniel Savigny.
This is called Nagasaki. arrangement of many arrangements. So it was written in 1911 by a man named Nat Ayer. This is called King Chanticleer. I have to credit Adam Swanson for a lot of these things, Brian Holland, Johnny Maddox, and a couple others. So this is King Chanticleer.
Version of the Hesitation Waltz, which was a popular dance step in 1914, and he calls it simply Hesitation Waltz.
Thank you.
Casey makes such beautiful music with so few notes. I feel bad to add any, you know? Speaking of adding notes, here is Mr. Nat Johnson's most famous composition, both apparently while he was still alive, and certainly today. This is also from 1914, and he recorded this one himself on a QRS piano roll in 1914. It was the only piano roll he ever made, and it's very good, and it proves that not only could he play it well, but he plays it exactly the same way he wrote it down on the sheet music, which is unusual because many other people would embellish beyond the sheet music, which was, of course, simplified for the folks at home who may not be an advanced vaudeville pianist like Mr. Johnson was. But apparently the sheet music accurately reflects what he intended, and I would play it like that. However, many other fine performers, including many people at this festival, already play it like that. And so far be it for me to be one of them, no disrespect to Mr. Johnson, I have another favorite version of this piece, Calico Rag. This one was recorded by Mr. Frank Banta, and he was about 19 or 20 years old when he recorded this. In 1917 for Columbia Records with Mr. Howard Cobb playing percussion behind him. And it's a wonderful record. It's a very spirited, lively 78 ragtime piano record, and you should check it out when you get home on Google. Luckily, Mr. Banta also made a piano roll of this exact same arrangement for the Aeolian Company, and it's note for note practically identical to the record. And my friend Mr. Luigi Rinaldi has transcribed that and graciously given me a copy of his transcription. So here's Frank Banta's arrangement of the Calico Rag by Nat Johnson. track for you of classic ragtime. The first is by Arthur Marshall, published in Sedalia, Missouri by Starr in 1907, called Kinglets. And then the second will be, what's his name? Robert Hampton. He wrote the Agitation Rag in 1915.
Thank you.
Lavolsi from Rhode Island.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I think what I'm going to do for you first, and I was discussing last night at the dinner table with one of the esteemed members of our ragtime community, Mr. Frederick Hodges, and he asked me what I was going to play today. And I told him, I have no idea. So he suggested, well, how about you play that one about your babysitter? I said, okay, why not? We'll play that. I'll bring that one in. So what he meant by that was a composition of mine from 2012, which is called Larkin Street Rag, named so because when I was very small and my brother and sister and I were all kids, we used to be watched by a friend of the family's on a street called Larkin Street. My parents would drop us off at the house, and we'd all run around and play and have great time, and it's a source of great memories for me and my siblings. So this is the Larkin Street Rag.
Thank you.
doing now is a piece by Scott Joplin that needs no introduction, but these are my own variations on the Maple Leaf Rag.
Thank you.
And I wanted to start off with it because I also wanted to fast forward now to 1900 to a song that was definitely influenced by that sort of writing that Blind Boone did. This is a piece from 1900, and it's very interesting because it has on it, in the style of a Mark Twain novel, a notice to the public before the printed music begins. It says that the subject of this composition is a resident of New Orleans, Louisiana, and is always seen carrying a chicken foot between his thumb and index finger. The fact is that he believes this to be an omen of good luck and meets the rabbit's foot. But the foot is actually attached to a live fowl stuffed up his shirt sleeve, hence his name, and the name of the piece, Chickenfoot Bob.
Love this website because they have thousands upon thousands of Victor records digitized and the audio cleaned up nicely, not poorly done, very nicely done. For your listening pleasure, everything from the early ragtime era through the early jazz era, and it's just wonderful stuff, classical music, operatic selections, ballads, waltzes, marches, rags, ragtime songs, everything, vocals, piano, banjo, you name it, and it's there, and you can search for it. It's a wonderful site, and I was listening to stuff from 1914, and I heard this wonderful record by a fellow about whom I know very little, Mr. George Wilton Ballard, who was a very fine singer, apparently, a very good tenor singer. I'd love to know about more about him. He didn't make very many records. But he sang this beautiful ballad called "You May Be the World to a World of Friends, But You're More Than the World to Me." And I thought, what a gorgeous title. And he sings it very beautifully on this record. You should really hear it. So I found the sheet music, and lo and behold, it's by the great American ballad writer Alfred Solman. Marvelous melody writer, so I shouldn't have been surprised. But this one's from 1914. So you're more, you may be the world to a world of friends, but you are more than the world to me.
Thank you.
had many requests for me to play something I wrote, so what the heck. Here's something I wrote 2 years ago for a girl whom I dated briefly, and it didn't go too well. It was mostly my fault, but anyway. She's still around and she's doing well, but 2 years after our failed attempt at a relationship, I started missing this girl incredibly, and I just couldn't stop thinking about her. And I thought, man, what am I going to do? This is affecting my sleeping, this is affecting my homework, this is affecting a number of things. So I decided to put my feelings into music. So without further ado, here's a little tune I call I Miss Tulasi, for Tulasi LaBelle. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I really appreciate that. Now it's my great pleasure to reintroduce the great ragtime man from Rhode Island, Mr. Frank Lavolsi.
Thank you.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce our next performer, who comes to us from the wonderful borough of Los Angeles. He studies at the Pasadena City College. He's studying music and history. He also teaches music. And he works at the Old Time Music Hall. I hope I got that name right. Please join me in welcoming Mr. John Reed Torres.
Thank you.
1917. And I'll wrap it up with a little short foxtrot from 1915, George L. Cobb, called The Rabbit's Foot.
Thank you.
that I would like to play for you is one of my absolute favorites. I came upon this actually in a documentary about vaudeville. American Masters on PBS did one, I believe, and there was this clip of Blossom Seeley singing this song. And this was back before the days of YouTube, so in order to see this clip, I always had to watch this documentary. Well, YouTube came around, and I was finally able to look this up, and it turned out to be a song by Cliff Friend called Hello Bluebird, and I just adore it, and I hope you do too. So here it is, Hello Bluebird.
Thank you. to end the concert with Tiger Rag. That was by Nicola Rocca in 1917. It's not really known who wrote this. It might be Nicola Rocca or Jelly Roll Morton or the original Dixieland Jazz Band. So this is in the style of Jelly Roll Morton a la Daniel Savigny, Tiger Rag.
See you for a whole day full of music tomorrow. Dinner time. Thanks.